Good afternoon. Honorable Minister Shri B.D. Kalla Ji, distinguished speakers, participants, ladies and gentlemen. As our Honorable Minister said, I also welcome you to the city of Jaipur. I begin by stating a fact that the only constant that we have is change. And the thing with technology is that it is all about change. In fact, very few of you would know that I am also an engineer. And one of the lasting impacts that I have from my first lecture, which happened in this field, was that anything that you're looking at when it comes to technology is, it will become smaller, it will become faster, and it will become cheaper. In fact, my professor had once said that the maximum shelf life of any product is 6 months. So you either make a business case out of it for 6 months, or somebody else will take it away. And we in the government have to leverage this advantage. The faster the change comes, the cheaper a product becomes, the sooner and quicker it is to help our citizens take advantage of technology. Our Honorable Minister mentioned a few examples. As a few of you would know, I am also holding charge of Principal Secretary Cooperative. In fact, that is my primary charge. And I will just dwell upon what technology can do to help us in improving our systems. He mentioned about the farm loan waiver scheme. The farm loan waiver scheme required that we are able to target the beneficiaries in an expeditiously simple and a quick manner. So what was done here was, we used the Aadhaar-based biometric system. The system uploaded what is the amount a particular farmer said that he owed to the bank. He verified it using Aadhaar. So we were able to remove all the complications of having a lot of paperwork attached to it, a lot of verifications which were required, and the whole system moved seamlessly, and in about 90 days, bulk of the task was accomplished. Getting one up from this, we decided that when we do the fresh disbursement, now what is happening is cooperative banks are doing an Aadhaar-based disbursement. That means a farmer comes to a e-mitra kendra, and I must mention here that in Rajasthan, the system is so strong, we have got 60,000 e-mitra kendras distributed all over Rajasthan. So he comes to the e-mitra kendra, he puts his thumb, we have got a database of 58 lakh farmers. So 58 lakh farmers, the database gets populated automatically, and this database has been verified to the level of the collector. So once that database is there, you don't need to get all those papers back. And depending on the crop that you're doing, the system pre-calculates what is the loan amount that you should be getting. And that amount is transferred through an FIG network into the account, which you can withdraw from any place where cash can be taken out. Another feature which has happened, which was of great use to us in the field of agriculture, was, of course, these are all based on that same principle of biometric authentication, is procurement. The state has done over 13,000 crores of procurement in the last two and a half years. And this is for pulses and oil seeds. And it has been a process, it's been something that we have been learning. What happens here is that a farmer registers with his thumb. And you know that we have got such a strong database. And once your registration happens, you are automatically given a date. That means we know at a procurement center, let us say I can tackle 100 farmers. So the system automatically, in a predefined manner, that is, those who register earlier are allowed to come earlier. You get a date on which you can come and sell your produce. And then obviously, as you might have guessed, the payment goes directly into your account. So these are features which have helped us make life easier for the farmers. The queuing system has removed the kind of waiting period that we used to have in our mandis. Another very interesting feature which is there in Rajasthan is that we've got a very strong GIS platform by the name of Rajdhara. And we are planning and we are trying to make sure that most of our schemes can utilize or leverage on this platform. The other initiative is Rajkaj. And as we speak today, this is one of those initiatives which is in for an award in the e-governance meet which is happening in Shillong, Meghalaya today. I would, when you people are here, I also request you to visit the command and control centers which have been set up in the 7 divisional headquarters. We are in the process of establishing it in all the district headquarters. The feature is very important is installation of cameras. and with the cameras trying to get intelligent information so as to improve the security environment in the state. We are also looking in terms of certain data analytics on this. We've got a history of a lot of photographs in all kinds of police thanas of people who have done some offense and we can't trace it. There are technological available. We have robots who can read it, who can assimilate it, and even make predictions on where we could find one of the fugitives. So that's a work in progress. The state has also set up possibly the most modern data center that any state government has. And I have also appealed to the organizers that if they have time, they can schedule a visit to this data center. The central feature, and it keeps coming back to me, coming from this background, is change. And technology is change, and what is most important is, and what is most pleasing is, it permits a lot of disruption. So one of the programs that the IT department does very well here is the startup program. As the Honorable Minister was mentioning, this is a self-grown government startup. We call it iStart. And we have got about 1,500 startups registered with us. The kind of work these startups are doing is absolutely amazing. They give us new insights of how we can improve our governance. If you permit me, I can just share a few. I was recently there in Udaipur, and one of the startups called Padharo has developed an app which is supposed to be a guide for people who are coming to Udaipur. What it does is it curates every experience in the town of Udaipur which any person who's wanting to visit should know. Where should he eat? What is the kind of a place that he should visit? What are the times for a good visit? If they're looking at traditional crafts, where do you actually get the good crafts? In fact, even if you are wanting to use a taxi service, which is a taxi service which does not fleece you, everything has been curated. The popular notion in Udaipur is, I have been a district magistrate there, that you don't need guides, and guides are not believable. But they are getting huge amount of downloads just on their application, which talks about a guide. And they said, if we share it with the guides available there in Udaipur, a lot of opportunities as far as employment can also get generated. So here is a startup working on a technology, curating the experiences, and telling us how we should be doing our job. So I believe startups have the potential to really disrupt the way we do things and also enhance the experience at every point. As I had mentioned, these startups are being incubated at a techno hub, and I've requested the organizers here that if they require, we can facilitate a visit, maybe sometime tomorrow, and I believe there's a lot to learn, and also look at the data center, which I was told today would be put into commission in the next 48 hours. There are a lot of other experiences that one could share with. I would have loved to be part of this for the full time of the event, because I see there are very good speakers, there are very good topics which are in here, but time constraint and otherwise, my apologies for that, but my team is very much here. And each of them have been tasked at looking at speakers, learning from whatever is being spoken, and taking it forward. I had got a very good reference for this event from a batchmate of mine, Jayesh Ranjan. In fact, he was here recently, I think on 30th of July, and he said, if anything, you must attend the this Techno Sabha, which is organized by the Indian Express Group. So I think that is how much it has traveled, that is how popular it has become. We are fortunate that you are here, and I hope that you keep coming back, not to Jaipur, to other cities of Jaipur. You'll find a very good environment in Udaipur, you'll find a good environment in Jodhpur. I think the Honorable Minister will be very happy to host you in Bikaner. So whichever way you look at it, enjoy yourself, do see the facilities I have been talking of, and my team here will be more than happy to help you in any way. Thank you. Jai Bharat, Jai Hind.